A West Australian man faces 5 life sentences and an order that he never be released for the brutal murder of his family in a suburban home in Perth. It's the first time the WA Supreme Court has used its power to order that an offender never be released from prison.
Anthony Robert Harvey was convicted of the murders of his wife Mara Harvey, their 3 children, and his mother-in-law Beverly Quinn.
On each count on the indictment, you are sentenced to imprisonment for life, with an order that you must never be released.
Harvey had pleaded guilty to the murders of Mara Harvey and their daughters, 3-year-old Charlotte and 2-year-old twins Alice and Beatrix, in September of last year.
They should have been able to trust their father to protect them. That is the most fundamental duty any parent has. You breached that trust and failed in that duty in the most extreme way imaginable.
The court heard the murders were premeditated, the children killed in their beds, and that Harvey planned to escape using funds he'd taken from his wife's bank account. The children's grandmother, Beverly Quinn, was killed when she came to the home the next day. It was several days before Harvey confessed to police.
In an ideal world, now that sentencing has been handed down, my family would return. But I know that this will never happen. Instead, we ourselves have been given a life sentence. Just like the sentence handed out today, but with one big difference, and that is we did nothing wrong and nor did my family. I think the sentencing today is extremely suitable.
In sentencing Anthony Robert Harvey, Justice Stephen Hall said he looked for a comparable case, but he couldn't find any. The nature of these murders was so brutal that it led the court to impose what is being described as the most severe punishment in Western Australia's history. Justice Hall noted the community's expectation of a punishment that suited the crime. The order that Harvey will never be released is the first time it's been issued in Western Australia. Aaron Fernandez, SBS World News.